In this session, we are going to discuss about computation of first and follow, the two important functions for constructing the parsers. Moving on to understand, first, we'll try to understand informally. Assume you have a clinic. Nowadays, this is becoming popular due to this pandemic. And you have only 5 appointments for a doctor. The appointments are only a representative number stating that you have 5 appointments. But each appointment can have more than one members if they belong to the same family. You just follow up, then under computation of first would be very easier for you. This is first position, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now, these appointments are a pre-booking basis and the doctor will be waiting for the patients to turn up. Suppose if the first patient turn up, what are the possibilities? Either he can be alone as an individual or he might be having their family. If there exists a family, you will have n number of patients in the family. There will be an order in which they will get treated. There is also a situation that this booking may get cancelled due to an emergency situation. And who will come first? Yes, it is this person. So today, based on yesterday's booking, who can be the patients that can be treated first by the doctor? The first, it could be the first patient if it is an individual, or if the first patient represents a family, one among that family which is already decided in order can be the patient which will be treated first, or if the entire family didn't turn up or the first booking didn't turn up, there is an opportunity for second to be the first treater. If second also didn't turn up, then there is an opportunity for third. And it goes on as long as you have emptiness in the corresponding booking or as long as the people didn't turn up. I hope this is very clear. This is just a scenario representing the treatment of a doctor based on bookings. Now, I'm just mapping this concept to the components of context-free grammar. We have terminals, non-terminals. These terminals you assume to be the individuals visiting to see the doctor. Non-terminals, you have a family. This family can again get expanded to n number of people, maybe the grandfather, grandmother, father, and a son. But this family tree has to be given first to the booking. The same gets applied to process also in our computer systems. Now, if you can understand this clearly, computation of first becomes very easier. Let's look at the construction of first. Just map what we have discussed. If there is a production, X gives epsilon, add epsilon to first of X. What does it mean? No bookings for today. The doctor is free. Okay. So, the bookings are equal to epsilon. Now, there is a production, X gives A. What is a terminal? X is A is a terminal and hence it is an individual who has booked for visiting the doctor. In which case, you have to add that terminal to first of X. That is, he is the one who is going to get treated by the doctor first. If there is a production, X gives number of symbols. So, what is this? Again, it is a, what's this? Yeah, it's a family now. When this is a family, whoever has already decided to come in order will be treated first. So what to do? You have to add first of Y1. Example, if in order to make it more clear for you in this case, let's see, S can get expanded using any of the production. If there is a production, S gives alpha 1, alpha 2 and so on up to alpha n. You can expand it using alpha 2, alpha up to n, alpha n. If alpha 1 is a terminal, okay, we'll stop with that. If alpha 1 is a non-terminal, let's say if the grandfather again has brought two of his sons or daughters, anything, then what will happen? There is a possibility to get expanded using beta 1, beta 2 and so on up to beta m. So in which case, it will get expanded to beta 1, beta 2 and so on up to beta m. So, this will go along as and when you have non-terminals in the first position. So, S gets expanded to alpha 1, alpha 1 gets expanded to beta 1. Beta 1, if it is a terminal, you can stop here or else you may get expanded. So, considering that, if you see, if Y1 is a non-terminal add its first to first of x. If first of y1 contains epsilon, so what does it mean? This family tree or this particular person doesn't turn up. Okay, so if he doesn't turn up, then automatically there is a provision for y2 to come in first position. That's why we are including both the first. So this y1 may also come first. If he didn't come first, y2 can also be treated first. If they didn't turn, y3 may get also treated first. If they didn't turn, and it goes on. And hence, if first of y1 contains epsilon, add first of y2 or first of y1 minus epsilon to first of y2. Okay, you have to remove that and you have to add. Hope this is clear, and we will move on to computation of follow, the second important function. Follow, as the name implies, it's the set of symbols that are following a particular symbol. So we know that terminals could not be or need not to be verified for this concept, because a terminal represents the final functionality. I assume there is a grammar G with some n number of productions, where S is the start symbol. I am trying to expand S with some productions. And again, this gets expanded, this gets expanded. This is a leaf node, okay? And it stops here, let us say. I have a leaf node and I have a leaf node. Now, what is followed after S? So what is S? S is a start symbol which gives this word. So what is that word? L, 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 followed by this L, followed by these three. So any word that are part of this grammar, once it is getting derived, what is expected? Yes, it is the delimiter. We all know that every string will end with a delimiter. So here in standard convention, we say dollar to be the delimiter or the end marker. So the start symbol, once gets expanded to generate the word, will obviously end up with the dollar, which is nothing but the delimiter. So what is follow of S? Yes, it will have dollar. Doesn't mean dollar is the only symbol, but if S is a start symbol, then you should add dollar to follow of S, because follow of S represents the set of all symbols that will come after expanding S. Once you expand X, what are all the set of symbols that will follow S will be the part of follow of S. So you have to add dollar. This is the first condition. Then, now you check. Suppose you have a production. Alpha, A gives alpha B beta. So, this is for expansion. See, for computing first, we look at the non-terminal on the left, because when A gets expanded, we look at the symbols that are part of this. But while looking at follow, we have to identify whatever is the list of symbols that are expandable. So you don't need to bother about this. So you have to bother about this. Okay. So it's enough to look at the right-hand side symbol. So alpha and beta, we don't know. Capital B is definitely a non-terminal. So what is follow of B? So what is the symbol that will follow B? Yes, it is beta. Okay. So it is equal to beta. Now, when beta is a terminal, okay, you can directly add. When beta becomes a non-terminal, what to do? Yes. What will follow this? Let us see with an example. Yes gets, yes, first I am expanding using the first algorithm. What's follow of A? What is following A? Yes, it is B, because whatever symbol you are expanding for this, after that, what will come next? Yes, it is the symbol B. So follow of A will be equal to B. We can add. Suppose if I use the second production for expansion, S gives A, B. What is following A? It's a non-terminal. When it is a non-terminal, again you will use B's production for expansion. Okay. Now in this case, there is only one symbol, which is C. So B gives C will be the production that we will be using. So what is C? Yes, it is first of B, right? So whatever symbols that come in the first position when you try expanding B will be the follow of A. So when you complete expanding A, whatever symbols that are following it will become follow of A. So What is follow of A? It is equal to first of B. Now, the third rule, which is more important, comes in. What if you have a production like A gives alpha B or A gives alpha B beta and first of beta times epsilon. Both are equal. You just check alpha B and alpha B beta. Here, what is the follow of B? Nothing. You don't have, so it is epsilon. Here, this is follow of B is first of beta, but first of beta contains epsilon. So, along with whatever symbols come, there is a possibility for epsilon also. So, it will leave out the production as A gives alpha B. So, what will be the follow? That's the next question. Now, let me make it more clear. Just look at this. Assume this is the given grammar. Now, when S gets expanded to A, B, B1, what is following A? Yes, it is B. So, when it is a non-terminal, you have two possibilities. If you expand it using this production, what is follow of A? Yes, it is A. Now, there is another option also. B1 can get, sorry, it is B, right? So, it will get expanded to C. So, follow of A will be equal to C in this case. So, what is following A? It is B. The B can get, we have only one option on this. B get expanded to C. So, follow of A is C. Suppose, what is follow of B1? Sorry, follow of B. So, what is followed after B? It is B1. Now, you have two options for B1. One, you can expand using A, in which follow of B will have A. Okay, B is followed by the symbol A. You have another option also. B1 can get expanded to epsilon. So, what is epsilon? This will go. Okay. So, what is the follow symbol of B now? C, S gets expanded to AB, B1. Now, B1 is substituted with epsilon, which means this particular branch will go off. The follow of this particular symbol, it is the follow of its parent. Right? Because if S is followed by dollar, that is the symbol that will follow after B if this goes off. So, that's the meaning of this. So, when this particular symbol goes off, or if you don't have a symbol over here, its parent follower. What is a parent? It is nothing but the leftmost symbol. So, what is a parent? If this goes epsilon, its parent, which is the leftmost non-terminal, its follow has to be included. So, I hope this is clear. We look at the rules now. If X is a start symbol, add dollar to follow of X. If there is a production, A gives alpha X beta. Okay, so what is follow of X? What is following X? It is beta. So, its first has to be added to follow of X. Now, this beta, if it goes epsilon, okay, if you don't have that symbol, or if its first contains a epsilon, in either case, you will end up with this kind of production. So, what to do? What is following X? Yes, it is the follow up of A. Okay. So, when there is no symbol after that particular thing, or if it contains epsilon, go back to its parent, which is the non-terminal on the left, and add its follow to follow of this corresponding. So, that's what is the procedure to construct first and follow. We'll move on to see some examples to make it more clear. Yes, given this grammar, there are two non-terminals, first of yes and first of follow. We have to compute. What is first of yes? X gets expanded to CC. Then the C, you have two alternates. If you use the first alternate, you will have C, in which case you have to add because it's a terminal. Then if the C gets expanded using the second production, you will end up with D, in which case you will have D. That's all. Or if you want to go to rule first of yes. What is the first symbol? You have a non-terminal. So, you have to include first of C. Okay. Now, what is first of C? It has two alternates where both the symbols are terminal symbols. So, it is C, D. So, just you have to write it over here. That's all. Very easy. Now, coming to follow. Follow of S and follow of C is what we are going to compute. What about S? It's a start symbol, so directly include dollar. Then look at the right hand side of all the productions, check whether anywhere S is there. No, and hence this is the only symbol. Now what is follow of C? You have to check whether C appears anywhere. It appears in three positions, here, here and then here. Now if you look at S gives CC, this is the first position where capital C appears. So what is following that? It is again capital C. So it's first. So what is following this? It's first. So follow of C is equal to first of capital C. Okay, union. It doesn't stop here because you have in two more places. Here SE is there. Okay, so it is not followed by any symbol. So what to do? Go to its parent, which is on the left, add its follow. So it is follow of capital S. Union. Then now come here. Look at here. Again, we don't have any symbol after this. So what to do? You have to go back and then add follow of C. Since it is the same symbol, you can stop. So finally, what will happen? Follow of C will be equal to first of C have to include, which is C comma D. And what about follow of S? We do have dollar. So that's how we have to compute first and follow. The next one more example. This is the given grammar. So there is only one non-terminal, which is first of S with three productions. Now look at the first production. It starts with the terminal symbol. Include it. Again, it starts with the same symbol. The third is also a terminal symbol. That's all. Very simple. Coming to follow. Follow of S. What to do? Since S is a start symbol, we have to include dollar. And S appears in three positions. See here, here and then here. So if you take this production, I gives S. I-S-E-S. This S is followed by this symbol. When it is a terminal, straight away we can include. When it is followed by an epsilon, which is an empty state, go back, include its follow. So since it is the same symbol, that's all. Again, you have S gives IS. Again, S is not followed by any symbol and hence go back to its parent, add its follow. Again, we don't have any symbol. So that's all. This is how follow of S needs to be computed. Then one more. This is a grammar for generating your arithmetic operations. First of, what is first of E? E has only one production, which starts with a non-terminal. So it will be first of T. So coming to T, again it starts with a non-terminal, which is equal to first of F. Come to F, there are two productions, both starts with the terminal symbol. So you can include left bracket comma ID. So all are same, left bracket comma ID. Now coming to first of E dash, the next non-terminal. Altogether we have five non-terminals. Again you have two alternates. The first alternate, if you take, it starts with terminal symbol. Second is epsilon. Then you have first of T dash, the same. You have two alternatives. The first alternate starts with star, the second is epsilon. That's how you have to compute first. Now, coming to follow. Follow of E. E is the start symbol and hence you have to include dollar. Follow of T. So what to do? In the right hand side, you have to check where and all T appears. It appears in two places. T is followed by E dash. Here also T is followed by E dash. So what to do? You have to include first of T dash. Sorry, E dash. So what is first of E dash? It is plus comma epsilon. As we already have seen, when epsilon is there, there is a possibility for this to go wrong. So what to do? You have to go to its parent, add its follow. Here the parent is same. Here, since it can be epsilon, you go back, add its follow. So you have to include follow of capital E. So it will be equal to plus comma dollar. Okay. Now follow of capital F. So check where and all F appears. Again, it appears in two places. In both the places, it is followed by T dash. So it will be first of T dash. So first of T dash has star, but it has an epsilon. When it is an epsilon, just go back, add its parent. So here it is T dash, but if you look at here, its parent is T. So follow of T, which is equal to star. Okay, what is follow of T? It has two more symbols, plus and then dollar. Fine. Now coming to follow of E dash. So where and all E dash appears? It appears in two places. Both the cases, there is no symbol following that. So its parent follow needs to be added. So follow of E. So what is follow of E? It has only one symbol, which is dollar. Then finally, follow of T dash, which is T dash is also not being followed by any symbol, and hence follow of T, because it appears in two position. Here in the second production, if you take T dash is not followed by any symbol, so you have to add its parent, which is T. So it will be plus comma dollar. I hope this computation is clear for you. We'll stop with this last example. S gives AC and other four productions are given. So what is first of S? It is first of A, since A is a non-terminal here. What is first of A? A has two alternates. One is A. Okay, if you take the first alternate, it starts with the terminal symbol. So I'm including it directly, union first of B, because in the second alternate, it starts with the non-terminal. So we need to compute first of B first. What's first of B? There are two alternates, both starts with B. So it is the only possibility. Then you have first of C. Neglect that last vertical bar. So it's two small c's together. So it will be small c. Now, when you substitute this over here, first of S equal to first of A will be equal to A comma include first of B, which is small. Just you can verify this when you, if you want to clearly understand, when you expand S to AC, when you expand using this, what are the possibilities? Either you can use small a, capital A, C as your alternate, again, which is A as the start symbol, it's there. What is the first of S? It is A, it is there. Or you can expand using the second production, A gives B, again, B gets expanded to BB or small b. Neither case, B becomes the first symbol. So it is correct. Then coming to follow. Follow of, initially the start symbol will include dollar. Then follow of capital A. Where and all A appears? Yeah, it appears in two position. In the first position, it is followed by capital C. Since it is a non-terminal, you have to use first of C. Union in the second production, it is followed by small c. So I have to include small c. So we already know what is first of capital C. It's also small c. So that is the only symbol that will be there. Then coming to follow of capital B. B is not followed by any symbol. So its parents follow need to be used. So follow of A, according to the production, A gives capital B. Union follow of capital B. According to the production, B gives B capital B. So it will be equal to, what is follow of A? Yeah, it is small a. Finally, what is follow of capital C? It is not followed by any symbol in the first production, and hence it is follow of capital S, which is equal to dollar. Hope you can understand the computation of first and follow.